My name is Evan Grabois, and I'm a head and neck cancer surgeon and healthcare delivery researcher in the Department of Otolaryngology and the Cancer Control Program at the Hollings Cancer Center. My research focuses on identifying and addressing the multi-level determinants of delays and racial disparities starting adjuvant therapy for patients with head and neck cancer. Our research is very collaborative and multidisciplinary in nature, and our research team incorporates expertise in population health, epidemiology, disparities, and mHealth or mobile health technologies. When I was on my second year in faculty at MUSC, I was awarded a K-12 Career Development Award from the Hollings Cancer Center. And this award was really instrumental in me getting my research program off the ground. It provided me with protected time. 75% of my effort was protected to devote to both my research activities and my scientific training. It also allowed me to develop a mentoring team with four mentors across the Cancer Center at Hollings to really help provide the necessary research training that I needed to become an independent researcher, and also gave me four fantastic collaborators to help advance the research that we needed. And so actually after our first year of pilot funding from Hollings, we were able to submit and get funded a five-year grant from the National Cancer Institute to advance our research program, identifying and addressing the barriers to delays and racial disparities starting adjuvant therapy for patients with head and neck cancer. The K-12 award from Hollings was absolutely instrumental to me getting my program of research up and off the ground. So by protecting 75% of my time to allow for focus on research and career development activities, I was able to take coursework that I otherwise wouldn't have been able to take. I was able to travel to seminars that gave me the necessary skills I needed. It let me network and meet other important researchers in my field that I wouldn't have had a chance to meet otherwise. It gave me a chance to really to grow and meet other researchers at Hollings Cancer Center who've since contributed to the research in very important ways and been part of the research team that we've developed here. The K-12 award also gave me my first chance to really learn about and develop my first investigator-initiated clinical trials. So coming into the award, I'd had really very little experience with taking a concept, turning it into a protocol, and then taking that protocol and actually testing the intervention, in the clinic with cancer patients to see what we were studying was working or not. And so the training that happened around clinical trials, both the design and conduct of the clinical trials, was a key part of the Hollings K-12 award and a key part of my research going forward. And so the Hollings award was very formative for me, both learning to love and embrace clinical trials and then incorporate them into my research as we move forward to test the different interventions to make sure that we're delivering timely and equitable cancer care. Having cancer stinks, and there's absolutely no reason that everyone, regardless of race, socioeconomic status, insurance, gender orientation, or language, should get anything other than the optimal cancer care. And unfortunately, we live in a system where disparities across many different constructs are very common, and they're entirely preventable. And being able to take all the amazing cancer treatments that other researchers at Hollings and across the country are developing and making sure everyone has access to them is a major way we can improve overall life and quality of life for cancer patients. And so that's why our team chooses to focus on understanding the structure and determinants of cancer care delivery, and particularly its impact on those that are more medically and socioeconomically vulnerable. So if I had one piece of advice for early stage investigators, or that I wish someone had told me when I was getting started on my research career, it would be really to surround yourself with a diverse and excellent group of mentors and work hard and consciously and proactively work with your mentorship team to leverage all of their special areas of expertise as you both build collaborators for your program of research going forward and enhance your ongoing scientific skills. And I think mentoring for some trainees is often very narrowly focused on developing scientific training. And there are a number of aspects of mentoring around team science that involve interpersonal skills, human management, and resources, and other aspects of building a program of research that are sometimes lost on trainees. And I think making sure you work with your mentors to globally develop to become the senior investigator you want to be is really a key part of how you make that transition from early stage investigator to accomplish an independent scientist.